Before we get started, I wanted to say that while we're not doing science, we will continue to wear face shields due to the current coronavirus pandemic. Hi, I'm Rachael. And hi, I'm Sarah, but I go by Dawson.
And I'm Hannah, today's special guest.
And hey, I'm Engie.
Today, we're going to do math. What's geometry?
Geometry is the math we do around shapes. For example, perimeter and area. Perimeter is the distance around the outside of a shape, and area is everything in between. So this is our deconstructed gingerbread house to practice measuring perimeter and area.
Awesome. So like this piece here, how would we measure perimeter and area of that piece?
Okay. So the perimeter is, as we mentioned before, the measurement around the outside. So let's just practice measuring with maybe marshmallows.
Let's do it.
Okay. So we'll take this whole glass of marshmallows and we're going to lay the marshmallows side by side to figure out how many, not that one, marshmallows it takes to go, let's say, one side. So Hannah, how many marshmallows is that side?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. That's 10 marshmallows.
10 marshmallows. Now, it took a really long time for me to lay those marshmallows out, didn't it?
Yeah, it did.
What if we had a standard unit to measure things?
Like a marshmallow?
Like a marshmallow, but what if it was something that just everyone around us already knew about, like maybe a ruler, like an inch?
That sounds handy.
All right. Well, I've got two rulers here. Do you want one?
I do.
All right. Well, I can find that I have inches on one side of my ruler.
Me too.
All right. Well, let's double check. Is an inch an inch? Let's put them together. So as we can see, an inch equals an inch.
Hey.
No matter what ruler we use. So it looks like this side that we know is equal to 10 marshmallows is equal to about 5 inches. And let me get rid of these marshmallows. Perfect. Do you want to measure this second side?
Oh, I sure do.
It's a little bit longer, so there should be a couple more inches.
That looks like 7 inches.
7 inches. All right, I will measure the third side, but I think that we'll find something interesting. It looks like that third side is 5 inches, just like the first one that we did.
Huh.
So if that side is equal to the first side, then can we say that the last side is also equal to the second side?
I think that sounds like a smart assumption.
All right. Yes, it is. 7 inches.
All right. So we measured each side. Is that perimeter?
Close. Perimeter is when we take each side and then we add those numbers together.
Okay.
So perimeter will be 5 plus 7 plus 5 plus 7. And that equals 24 inches. So we know that there are 24 inches all the way around this side of the gingerbread house.
So what do we use perimeter for?
That's a really good question. What do you think we would need to go around the side of a gingerbread house?
Frosting.
Yes.
Let's frost the perimeter. To calculate the perimeter of a rectangle, we need to measure a side. Add the second side. Add the third side. And then add the fourth side. Way to go!
Well, what if we wanted to fill in an entire square with frosting?
That is a very good question. If we wanted to fill this whole surface of one of the sides or maybe the roof, then that's called area.
Okay. How do we measure that?
Okay. Area uses multiplication. So we might need to get our thinking caps out.
All right. I'm ready.
Okay. So area would be if we take two adjoining sides, which means that they're connected, two sides, and we multiply that together. That's how we find area of a square or a rectangle. Yeah, so you've written down 5 times 7. Can you think about what 5 times 7 equals?
Let's talk about area. To calculate the area of a rectangle, we need to measure a side. And we also need to measure a connecting or adjacent side. Then, we can multiply. So what is 5 times 7? Good luck!
All right, so we have 5 inches times 7 inches. That gives us 35 inches squared.
Inches squared?
Yeah, so because we're measuring area, we have inches times inches. And that gives us inches squared. That's the unit we use to measure area.
That seems simple enough. All right, now that we know perimeter and area for measuring the gingerbread house, do you think we have enough information to actually build the gingerbread house?
I feel ready.
That sounds really good, but I have a question. What about people who build real houses?
I bet they have to use area and perimeter as well.
Yeah, so I guess it's pretty important that we know how to measure area and perimeter. Well, now we have enough information to build a gingerbread house.
Let's do it.
I think we need a new house. Oh, excellent.
Let's take some measurements.
Okay, I'll measure this side. It looks to be about 6 inches. Okay, I'll measure the front. It looks to be about 5 inches. Can you find the perimeter for the base of the house?
Can you calculate the perimeter?
Can you help us find the area of the house? That way we know how much carpet to put in.
How about the area? Try calculating that.
Thank you for building gingerbread houses with us.
If you like this video and want to see more like it, check out our YouTube channel, Engie Does STEM.
Please like and subscribe.
We're wishing you a happy holidays.
Man, this is so many gingerbread houses.
It sure is.
What should we do with them?
We could eat them.
I have a better idea.
Thanks, everyone. See you next time.